Respect. Good day, everybody. I don't bring Una another good news again. Wait, I brought you guys a very good news. Anyway, I'm sure I'm going to be spending some good time in this video. But please, you that is watching or listening to this video now, don't fail to listen to the end, because if it's not of use to you that is hearing me now, it will be of use maybe to your friend or somebody close to your friend or somebody close to you. First and foremost, Happy Democracy Day, Nigeria. Today is June 12th. June 12th, the day we accepted and the day we accept as Democracy Day in Nigeria. Not May 29. No, May 29 is a scam, so we don't accept that. And I will also use this medium to say kudos to Mr. Omoyele Sowore for bringing out for bringing it out again, making the Nigerians know that yes, it is June 12, not May 29. If not, the government of Nigeria, the today government of Nigeria, they have already agreed and adopted May 29. But thank God Almighty, they are now collecting some awareness. They are now getting some ideas from what Omoyele Sowore said during the presidential election campaign 2019. But we are in 2020, and we are planning the governorship election in Edo State. Oh, Edo Wayeme Yeah, I really want to talk to everybody, though. The motive and the purpose for this is the forthcoming or the upcoming governorship election there in Edo State. Wabiwinege kai Iwedume. In short, itwira itwiye itwikbia itwikwo. Ituomo bo, ituomo we, ituakpa, novireko. Edo ama, mavi amao. And ive kabo wa yase fena, we ya niruwe, obuyo bitoa. Ge utedu, amani maya. For those that doesn't understand English, I greet fathers, I greet mothers, I greet boys, I greet girls, I greet the little children, even those that are still inside their mother's womb. I greet everybody. Thank God Almighty that the African Action Congress, AAC, has gotten a candidate that will also contest for the governorship election that is coming up on the 19th of September 2020. The reason why I am very happy today is some time ago I did a video encouraging the Edos to look for woman, that they should present woman as their candidate there in Edo State. I got a message today that yes, the African Action Congress Party has come to settle the dispute in Edo State. The African Actions Congress, which is AAC, has decided to put smiles into the citizens, everybody that is from Edo State. Before we give you details about the person, She is a woman. The African Action Congress, the AAC party, has brought out a candidate which is a woman. But before we, I will tell you the details about this lady, this woman, let me tell you guys why we really need to look onto her. Why we really need to look. I'm not saying AAC as a party now. No, I am talking as the person the African Action Congress brought out to as the governorship aspirant for the forthcoming Edo State governorship election, which will be held on the 19th of September. We need to look onto our home, man. Please, my brothers and my sister, the solution now for the problems we have been complaining of, the things we have been complaining of, the solution is now in our doorstep. The solution is now with us. But I pray Almighty God that the words you're going to hear from me will not only enter your ears and go out, but you will act to it. I am not the type that talk because somebody gave me money. If not, I would have danced to the tune of so very many politicians there in Nigeria. But because their agenda and their purposes are not encouraging, are not good for we the common masses, I place myself with those below. Yeah. So I don't want to be among any of those. But today being the 12th day of June 2020, I am here to talk to you as a brother. I am here to talk to you as a son. I am here to talk to you as a servant. I am here to talk to you guys as somebody which you all sent on an errand and now is coming back with the message you sent him. Please pay attention to this video, most especially those in Edo State and those die-hard AAC member, African Action Congress. This is another good opportunity for us to take that which we have been longing for back. They say a journey of 1,000 kilometers begins with a step. 2019, the African Action Congress Party emerged, we comes out. Though it started like in from 2018, but officially I think 2019, the party was being placed. Before I go to the Edo State aspirant, I want to use this video to plead and to beg everybody, most especially those our members that are African Action Congress members. When I mean our members, we have the serious ones and we have the non-serious ones. So whether you're serious or not serious, this is the time for us now to start from somewhere. This is a governorship election. If we as the AAC take it back, can be able to do it in Edo State, automatically through Edo State we can spread our tentacles to other places, even as far as to the presidency. The presidency election will be coming up 2023, but we have to start it now. How do we do this? A lot of us knows how we can do it. A lot of my comrades, they have been working towards the success on how it's going to be in 2023. But this is another good opportunity. This is another great opportunity for us now to show ourselves to the people there in Nigeria. This is a governorship election, and I will still use this medium to talk to the federal government of Nigeria that the band which is being placed to our chairman, Mr. Omoyele Sowore, should be reconsidered, because we need our chairman, Mr. Omoyele Sowore, during this time of the campaign there in Edo State. I know it's going to be very difficult for the federal government to do that because they are the APC and they really want their own person to win the governorship election. But they should have it at the back of their mind that if they should do that, automatically they are adding more bad records to their record. If because you know that, yes, giving Omoyele Sowore the freedom to assist his party, our party in Edo State for the campaign towards the forthcoming governorship election, if they still insist to keep him in Abuja, restrict his movement to only Abuja alone, him being the party chairman, that is to say they have a lot at heart. And we will still write it down for the future sake that because we know the APC and the PDP to be a party which doesn't mean good for Nigerians or good for the states they are ruling, that is why they still hold Omoyele Sowore not to go and assist the party and its people towards any election we're doing. September is just around the corner. So the federal government of Nigeria, the High Court of Justice, whosoever is responsible for Omoyele Sowore injustice condition not to move out of Abuja, should be able this time give him the priority to assist the party in the upcoming Edo State governorship election, because we really need our chairman now. But it's something I'm going to say. It's not something I'm going to use my force, my power to do. That is for that as the party. We have a very good person. When I say very good person, yes, as far as she is a lady, a woman, that is coming out to contest as a governorship candidate under the Party of African Action Congress. That is to say, there is light now coming to Edo State. But before we go any further, let me give you the details about this person which the AAC party is presenting to the Edo State. Then later, I will tell you why we need to make it work. Just a minute. Yeah, I'm very sorry, you understand. I'm not good in googling people. And what you're about to hear from me is not as a result of Google. If you even go to our YouTube channel or our pages, things like that, is what we get there. This is who she is. It is not like those people that are forging certificate or those people that are saying something they cannot meet up to. No, this very lady is serious. And even before she emerged or before she comes out to say she wants to contest as a governor in Edo State, if you guys are following me perfectly, I have made several videos telling the Edos that we need a woman. We should trace back to our origin. This, anytime there is problem in our land, the solution always comes out from the woman. So we should not modernize it. Because we are trying to modernize our tradition as Edo State or as Benin Kingdom, that is why a lot of things has been happening in Edo State. Because we face to look at some valuable things, or in the name of modernization, we begin to experience some modern things which are not supposed to be happening. The killings, the looting, the bad environment, the lack of respect, the insult to elders, all these things is as a result of trying to modernize. Yes, it is good to adopt to development. It is good to modernize, you understand? But we should not forget where we are coming from. Neither should we forget where we are going to. We are made for greater things, more than what we are experiencing today. I just want to give you why I'm opening my book. I don't write my speech down. I don't talk from what is written down. I normally talk from experience. But because this very person, I don't know about her biography that much, I went to make my own inquiries, of which I now discover that, yes, she is the best person. She is the good candidate. And she should be the one to take Edo State to the next level. But I will not use the word next level, because that is a word which they have used to like deceive a lot of us. So I will say it like this, that this lady is the one that will bring what really our ancestors has wanted Edo State to be. Don't forget, women are always the source of every great man. Behind every good and successful man, there is a woman. So if the woman now decides to come up to do it publicly, let's give them a chance. The AAC candidate, which has gotten to my notice, and which, by the grace of Almighty God and the power of the Enikaor of Edo Land, she should be the one to lead us. Her name is Edith Iwegian Isokma. Edith Iwegian Isokma. She has a BSc certificate in government and public administration. She went to university. She studied it. She has the certificate to how to organize the government, how governments work. She studied it in the university, not like the conflict we are seeing presently among those they call themselves the ruling party. They are the one now exposing themselves to us. Ah, it's forged certificate. Hey, he didn't go to school. This one, that one. So, this lady, Edith, she went to school to study it. And apart from that, listen, she also has a master's degree in international law and diplomacy. Master degree in international law. So, she knows what the law is talking about, both as in Nigeria or as in the world in general. When we say international law, she studied international law and diplomacy in the school, which is the governorship aspirant under the canopy of African Action Congress, AAC Party. You guys should listen. Please take your time to hear me out. Why we need this lady to be the governor, and how it's going to benefit every members, every citizens of Edo State. Apart from these things she studied in the school, getting a BSc, like a BSc in the government and the public administration, she also has a master in international law and diplomacy. She is also an associate fellow of the Nigeria Institute of International Affairs, Sister Beauty from Uwode local government there in Edo State, the governorship aspirant under the party of African Action Congress. She's cooperating, she joined hands together with a very great organization which goes by the name of Nigeria Institute of International Affairs. Let me break it down. Whenever you hear them talk about problem, Nigeria's problem with other foreign countries, she has the wisdom to share light on how they can resolve this issue. And don't forget, she has a master in international law and diplomacy. Those we have been putting in office ever since, they are still now arguing for certificate, this and that. So if illiterate, let me put it like that, illiterate, if somebody that can go and forge certificate, it doesn't have any valuable thing to show, we normally call them illiterate. If an illiterate can govern us for this many years, and we are saying that, yes, they are not doing anything, apart from maybe when we see something like this through social media, they hear it, they will not put it in practice. Like, for example, during the campaign of Omoyele Sowore, 2019, during the presidential election, Omoyele Sowore said publicly that when he becomes the president, he's going to make June 12 today the official Democracy Day for Nigeria. But because those in power, they don't know, they don't even know, they don't study it, they don't care to know about it, all they are after is the money. They heard it from Sowore, but now today what is happening? They are adopting to what they heard from Sowore. My people, for us to Congo, they follow down and when they copy idea, we not get anything for himself. Then, me will embrace the one and be say yes. Now they bring the idea come outside when these people they use. So that Ingo Fit use that idea to repair everything. It doesn't end there. The shocking part of this very lady, Sister Edith, that is contesting as governor, the shocking part is what I want to say now. In 2019, this lady contested for a seat in the Edo State House of Assembly, where they make the law, where they pass the law that govern Edo State. This lady contested for a seat so that she can represent Uwode local government in the constituency there in Edo State. But because of mago-mago of the APC and the PDP, because of injustice, I cannot say she didn't win the election. Neither will I say she lose. But instead, that seat that this lady contested for 2019 to represent the Uwode constituency there in the Edo State House of Assembly, that seat is still vacant till today as me and you are talking. Nobody is occupying that place. And if nobody is occupying that place, automatically, the whole of Uwode don't have somebody to fight for them. For example, if they are sharing money now, go and use this money to do road in Oriomo, Iyekovia, this one, that one. There is nobody now that they will say, you take, go and do the road in Uwode. But this lady contested for that position in 2019. They didn't give her this position. They didn't give nobody else. Automatically, the whole of Uwode now, they are suffering. Though they might say they are enjoying, but they are suffering because the benefit that is supposed to be coming from the government, there is nobody now to bring it from the government to them. The government might bring 1 naira now and give them, whereas the money that is budgeted for them is 1 million. That seat is vacant till today. But because we know it whether no kwamakia or mama there, you that is pursuing somebody, you are the one showing the person road. She decided that out of her own wisdom, based on she has studied, she has known a lot of things, that no, she has to go for the governorship. And by the grace of God, we wish her to become the governor. Because if she becomes the governor of Edo State, believe me honestly, Edo State will be transformed from 1% which we are now to 101% automatically. I so much believe that when a woman comes to power, things will change. Because the women are the ones that give birth to everybody on earth. So no woman will want to see his or a child suffering. Give woman a chance. Please, I want to now go straight to my own point. I'm done with the reading. I've given you details about this lady biography. Now let us talk. Let us talk now. Let's talk as brothers. Let's talk as sisters. Let's talk as human beings. I know some of you will be asking or contemplating in your mind, what about the project Obaseki is handling? What about this? What about that? Let me tell you why we need to kick those people out of government and bring in new person. These people have been rotating power because of the atrocities they've been committing. They never want us to know they are bad. They never wanted us to know they are evil. And the only way we can know these things is for us to have a new person, a different person entirely, that can really bring these things to our notice. On a very fair ground, my people, government, when it read the work, we should not be asking ourselves that, we should if we didn't give Obaseki chance now to finish his project, who is going to finish it? Government does not work like that. But you know why most of you are thinking like this, or thinking what you're thinking in your mind right there? It's because of the mentality we are having. If Obaseki is constructing a drainage in Edo State, at least those things should be in records, so that whosoever that is coming behind, you don't need to go and meet Obaseki directly to know exactly what is happening in the state. He's supposed to go to the agenda, the profile, the contracts, everything. He or she is supposed to read it from a book, see it from, not from human being. That is one mistake we are making there in Edo State. I cannot say in Nigeria now. Yes, it is the mistakes of Nigeria. But let me talk about Edo State. Because Lucky Gbenedion did what he wanted to do, nothing was kept in record. Other people that comes do whatsoever that they wish to do without records. Don't forget, anything you're doing without keeping record, it is agberoism. Something you do, you that's, I cannot read it from book. You did something, then you are waiting to come and explain it to me. That is the kind of government we don't want in Nigeria. That is the kind of government they have been operating that is making us to be complaining to date, because there is nothing documented down for the next person to come and see. Instead, they believe in, okay, I am going out now as a governor. You are coming in. Okay, come, let me show you my project, or let me tell you what I've been doing. You don't need to tell somebody what you have been doing when it comes to public facilities. Those things should be documented somewhere, so that when the person that is coming to take over from your office gets there, He don't need to confront anybody. He goes straight, or she goes straight to the programs, what you have written down. Ah, okay. There is a drainage going on in Kenwa Road. Good. Ah, so contract was awarded to Julius Berger. Good. Yeah, that person should be able to check those things from a written document. But it does not happen that way. And this is where I really need to talk to people like Kabaka, other people. Sorry, Kabaka, I always mention your name because you are a good man, you are a bad man. Take it like that. You know why people say you are a bad man? Because the government you have been working with, I'm talking to you, Kabaka. I will really need you this time. Kabaka, we need your knowledge, we need your power in AAC, not in APC or in PDP. Tony Kabaka, you have a knowledge that is useful, but the people you have been working to have been operating you like a tout. But the African Action Congress will not do that to anybody. Now, they didn't drop anything down for us to read. They keep saying it. This lady that is contesting under African Action Congress will not do such thing. She will document everything because she knows that the power is not forever. And she will do her best to make sure that, yes, anybody that is coming after her, we have something to go through without even calling her to say, come and explain to me. You will see everything transparent. That is the kind of government we need. Now, let me talk to Kabaka and some other people directly again. They have been saying Agbero, Agbero, Agbero. It is Agbero that has been operating. Yes. And there is a way we can reverse it. I'm talking to those people now that they have been... Okay, just imagine. They say Tony Kabaka and his squad na Agbero. Obaseki drove them away, no? Then he now bring in another set of Agbero. Like the what is his name? Crack Team Boss, Abato Baze, and some other people. They believe because they can talk on social media, showing us some certain things, that they are learned. No, they are not. They are the same set of Agbero in a different ways. Has it gotten to your knowledge, you, Abato Baze? You, Tony Kabaka, that we learn from what happened to other people. Okay, as great as Bob Izwa, I repeat, Bob Izwa, Kabaka, your elder brother, as great as Bob Izwa in Edo State, what happened? We can't even hear his voice again. Somebody that has done very, very many great things. But we can't hear his voice again. You know why? Those people that are using you guys only have one mentality. They use you as a thug. They dump you as a thug. They use you as an agbero. They dump you as an agbero. They use you as a tout, they dump you as a tout. But AAC, African Action Congress, we never do that to anybody. No, because it is in our manifesto that it is the duty of the government or the party to pick an agbero from the street and make that agbero an official worker. It is the duty of the government or the party to pick that tout from the street and make that tout useful in a legal way, not illegal ways. Okay, now take for example, Bobby Zwa was the backbone of Lucky Igbinedion. But because Lucky Igbinedion fails to empower Bobby Zwa. Now, what is empowerment? He failed to empower Bobby Zwa. You don't just keep on giving somebody money without giving the person the knowledge or the ways to cover to cover those things. It's bad. That is why we call it agberoism. But in this upcoming election, I will plead and beg to all those people they call agberos. You guys are not agbero. No. Don't let nobody paint you differently for what you are doing. You guys are very, very useful in the government system. The only thing the government did to you guys that I personally, Kompasike, what I don't like is they fail to expand your memories. They fail to secure you that has given them the victory to be in that office. The only thing I will be so bold to say here now through this live video to those of you they called agberos is you guys are not agbero, but you have to allow the African Action Congress do that for you, because you cannot do it on your own. You have been labeled thugs, you have been labeled hire killers, you have been labeled agberos, because those you work with face to give you another regard. They face to raise up your morale. Instead, they keep you where you are because they want to still use you again. And the time has come now again that they will still want to use you. The time has come now that you will still want to act like the agbero they are calling you. The time has come now that you still want to act like that talk they are calling you. But I beg you people, don't give these people that chance to start labeling you the names that are supposed to go to them. To start with, those we call our governor, like me, I have to mention names. Starting from Lucky Igbinedion, Adamu Shomole, to the present governor Obaseki. Those guys are reserving you guys with a bad name, agbero, talks. This is the time, my brother Tony, about Obaze, this is the time for you guys now to rebrandish your name so that people will not call you guys agbero again. People will not call you thugs. Let me just throw only one light, because this time around, we are very careful not to sell out our ideas to those that will not make use of it. Even if they make use of it, they will want to still consume the glory. Let me just give you one reason on how that can happen. Take for example the time that you, Tony Kabaka, is with Adamu Shomole. Then Adamu Shomole now call you Tony Kabaka because of what you are doing, so that people don't begin to call you agbero, things like that. I want to create an office under the government. You invent things to eradicate poverty. The government has the power to invent just to create job opportunities. If Obaseki or Adamu Shomole has been able to officially create one office, for example, say for them to be calling you guys agbero or that or this, he now said we are creating in Edo State Ministry of Truth. It is allowed. The government has the veto power to create Ministry of Truth. to be aired by Tony Kabaka, you have already gotten an official office already. And with your official office as Ministry of Truth, Tony Kabaka is the Minister of Truth. You organize your people officially. Today, you have machines to print out some papers because you will not want to be using your mouth now or your power now to go to the street. And no, instead, you will have a secretary now, Tony Kabaka, the Minister of Truth in Edo State. You create it, create offices. Secretary, you only are your market event now. I'm here no shady le look pony. My money are shady yo, but Aki Ariva, we were printed be well. If it from so day, nobody should be shading on the street. So before that day, anybody no any rukpo, nor the Ministry of Truth, so that you guys can make allocation. It can all VM your gallery, things like that. Officially, your secretary print the paper. Then your boys, when they call Agbero, they will not call them Agbero again. They will call them task force to the office of the Minister of Truth. I'm a motto. If they see the motto, Ministry of Truth coming, I respect. Not when they see you coming. They say, Yage, Tony Kabaka video, Agbero video. No, this time around, they will label you officially. Why am I saying this to you, Tony Kabaka, and every other people that they are calling Agberos? I am saying this because I want you guys to please join hand with the party that has something to offer me, offer you, offer everybody. I know a lot of you will be saying, we brought this APC to Edo State, we brought PDP to Edo State. It's a do or die affair. Listen, the same way you guys bring those parties to Edo State, but today they are now even giving you some bad names. That is the same way I am begging you guys. One near one name, those of now when they just call Agbero. Listen. Those people when don't use una, they don't really brand una, give una good things. Instead, their own, they secure. Una own, they destroy. Adam Oshomole has, they not scatter up. But Tony Kabaka hotel, they scatter up. Lucky Bine the own things when he do, they not scatter up. But this one, they scatter up. So more think, I beg. And more not forget, una when they call the Agbero, now una be the pillar of the government. If una still join Adam Oshomole today, kick Obaseki Komot. This same Oshomole, he go still the see una like Agbero, still the see una like that. Instead of that one, I beg una, Mona forget this yes sir, yes sir, yes sir. Mona forget this God for that reason. Wajako Bokubi, eh? Nagbinyanifwa. They quarrel now, they fight now. Now our own property, our own things, now they think they settle because now we they call Agbero. Tony Kabaka. Abaze, today, now Tony Kabaka turn. Abaze, tomorrow, now your own know. Not to say you they do some things now because of say you wise, they don't know. And I lie. Everybody know everything where everybody gets. Everybody know. The only way when general peace go feel rain for that Edo State, now be when. You leave Oshomole, this one leave Obaseki, the other one leave the Ize Yamu, they will come say, no, this now are those things supposed to be. This now how we want them. Not be how they want them when they tell us. If we not learn how to say no to all these political leaders when it comes from APC and PDP, now that same name when on the beer, now on our city beer, Agbero, Tout, this one, that one. But by the time we think twice, say no, enough is enough. Embrace this new party the way Una first say embrace those other parties when they can't get level. We don't say and say yes, those parties now they know they help us, then they destroy us, destroy our property, destroy our future. Now, woman,
woman now nine they come from African Action Congress. It could be very, very good. Say yes, all of us join hands. Make this woman, make that African Action Congress take over those people when don't to use us, when don't to give us bad name. They no go fit to repair una again. Tony Kabaka, PDP and APC no go fit repair the name when they don't already give una. The only thing when go fit repair the name now when people they call una, now una go still decide for una self, say enough is enough. Embrace that new thing. Support that new thing. The one that takes support those other people. Then, all those Agbero, all those other yeyeni, when they call us, when they call una, it could change, it could change. I beg. I will still beg one last thing. For the now, we are all brothers and sisters. Those social media presenter, a lot of force when it comes from Edo State now, women. I go beg una, Yore one of Paris, oh, African German First Lady, oh, True Dream, oh, Rita Mali, oh, all of una when they do social media presentation. I beg, make una. Not they talk only about APC and PDP. Abe mona join me, mona join Compassi KY. That woman, I not say the party now, Edo State now don't get governorship election when go happen on the 19th of September. Now for eyes, now for far. Abe mona still use na platform, take publish that our sister when he first contest as member Edo House of Assembly to represent one their constituency when they not really give and when they say the seat still vacant today. That same lady now they come out again now to come contest for governorship. I beg Mona still help me use on our channel. See propaganda Mona spread the woman to our fans, to our people. Mona not forget, see, right from the time for that Benin Kingdom, that Edo State, if things don't get a baby as a biggie, you biggie, now women, now they make up, it will constantly be gidigba. I use God beg. Our presenters, Mona assist this, our sister Edith. Sister Edith, when the contest under the Party of African Action Congress. Mona still help her spread the news so that it will reach the ears of everybody. It don't reach time when BC Edo State not go to talk say now only PDP we know or APC. Since we talk PDP APC, where we dey, now we still dey. It don't reach time for election now, Nana Obaseki. Project we're supposed to do for the past 3 years, Nana it dey rush the do one. So that una Okongo look that one, still put her for power. Once he win the election again, those projects una go yes in a abandoned project. They not they finish their project. He go won't leave her with who they come because their mentality too low. Now just one thing that they rotate the money. Road this, that. No one they get hurt. But if we decide now say okay, yes, this new person, this new party may they go there. Believe me honestly. Adam Oshomole, he not fit give Edo State light. He not even fit build any good thing when he go create job for Edo State. But go see the estate, abi the small country when he build under his own name, under his own destiny. Then who is fooling who? You say 4 years, abi 8 years, not reach you take repair Edo State. And we not even see one better thing when you do. But the 8 years reach you. They give yourself everything when you define. Now that kind of life you want to live for those days continuously. 8 years when not reach you, take repair, wait till they say make you repair, do wait till they say make you do as a governor. But the eight years, it reach you, they thief the one when go belly for you. It reach you, they build the one when go belly for you. It reach you, they do the one when benefit you alone. But it not reach you do the one when it go benefit all of us. Now that kind of people are still defined. Obaseki say 4 years, not reach and they do anything. I never see one thing when Obaseki do. Apart from they say, if they do road, if they do this one, if they do that one, I use God beg on her. Tony Kabaka, I beg you. You know why they call your name? Because you're not still popular figure. You understand? It could be very, very wise. Say, you yourself, you know where your problem for the come now. And face it directly. About the crack team boss. I feel that you say you don't crack. You need amendments. Amendments don't come now. If you know anything good for you, Abaze, think twice. Stop those your blind propaganda about Obaseki. Obaseki, they do this. Obaseki, they do that. Stop them. Face your own reality. Up till now, the other day, I tell you, say, tell us, what will be your position for inside this present government? You know, even go think. This one, that one. But I don't already give you the loophole for you now. I don't give the expo for you now. Your governor should be able to invent, create something officially under the emblem of government when it will be legal. Everything on the do so now illegal. And no surprise, when the time come, now Kabaka will tell them destroy. Make them not go destroy your property. Even you yourself, you know, can't see you. They'll go lock you for one place when they say, you know, can't see sun. We are upgrading every day. I beg. I use God beg on her. Edo State, make we embrace this new party. Most especially, the woman. Finally, African Action Congress. AAC, take it back. Soon and very soon, we are going to take it back. Soon and very soon, we are going to take it back. Soon and very soon, we are going to take it back. Very soon, AAC will take it back. Please, African National Congress, let us do everything possible to support Sister Edith Imegian to become the governor of Edo State so that we can start from somewhere. At least if she becomes the governor of Edo State, from the activities she will be doing, that will make the country know exactly what AAC as a party can do for them. Thank you very much. I love you guys. I'm Compassy KY. Before I go, I really want to re-sing that thing again. Soon and very soon, we are going to take it back. Soon and very soon, we are going to take it back. Soon and very soon, AC will take it back. Very soon, AC will take it back. No more kidnapping, if AAC would take it back. No more joblessness, we should take it back. No more light, no day, if AAC would take it back. I say very soon, please let us take it back. I love you guys, till we see very soon. I'm Compassy KY, your brother, your friend, your son. Vote AAC in the upcoming Edo State governorship election. Vote Edith for governor. God bless you.